go to Salado over there in Montana.
Alright, let's do it then.
Alright.
Starting it up. Oh, I gotta do a little. Bonjour! Welcome to another episode of the Johnny R Show. I am Johnny R, and my special guest today is Mr. Brian. What is your full American name?
My full American name given me by the government is Brian Hundley.
Brian Hundley.
Yeah.
Brian Hundley, also known as Soup Juice. Soup Juice to the crowd, to the many fans out there. But I just want to thank our studio, C's Coffee Shop. Thanks for letting us hang out here. And C's Coffee Shop is open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. And closed on the weekends because of golf. No, I don't know. I just made that part up. But yeah, just want to do a... Yes, sir. Can I help you?
What is this? How's it going?
Good. What's up?
Not much. How's it going, buddy?
What's going on?
Cool. Fan?
All right. Awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's good to meet you. How's it going?
Good.
Used to be a
co-star,
but he fired me.
He got fired. Oh, yeah? This is why he got fired. What time did we say?
Oh, okay. He's late.
5:30.
Hey, what?
That's Indian, why he got fired.
What Indian made it in on time?
So you're at 5:15, baby. He was here right behind me.
Right behind
we
you.
We waited as long as we could, so.
Oh,
man, this guy.
Ah.
It's the business. It's the business, man.
Hey, man, customer, you can see I'm introducing
it's business.
Business. I'm helping out.
It's business. It's
so
bad business.
So what's going on there, Johnny R?
Not much. Just interviewing the man, the myth, the legend, the Facebook phenomenon.
Yeah.
That's one thing I wanted to get into. Like, I don't know, when you first started your Soup Juice videos, when was your first, do you know the exact day you did your first video?
My first video was back in, I think it was in early February or November.
Mm-hmm.
And I did it in the living room. It was just a Soup Juice video. It was a video introducing myself as Soup mm-hmm. Juice. And I basically, you know, bagged on duck lips. I got tired of seeing everybody doing the duck lips and stuff like that. So I said, hey, Soup Juice says no more duck lips.
Mm-hmm.
And I just put it out there and everybody just caught on because, you know, duck lips were played out. Still are, I think, but that's just my opinion.
Selfies all together are pretty
good. Oh, yeah. Selfies, all
sick of
all
people.
That. Yeah, I just got
the faces,
it,
you know. What's we it? Know what they look like.
Yeah.
But yet they keep putting up. Some people take pictures with suckers all the time.
Yeah.
Well, some guys are just funny.
Some guys are.
They gotta be out there, you
some
know.
Guys are. With they, guys with suckers in
they,
their mouths. Who
have,
does that?
They have to represent. Do you know how much they're helping at girls, though? The stuff I do gets me women. You know, is the stuff I say on Facebook helps me get girls, and nobody knows that. I keep all my stuff on down, though. I act like I'm out there, I'm lonely, I need a girl, but I have girls with me all the time. I had a girl with me yesterday, a girl with me today, you know what I mean? It works.
Mm-hmm.
And I spit it. Just kidding.
And,
can I say, what's that? Sorry, bro. I love that word, split it. I mean,
all right, man.
You
now,
go, everywhere you hear that now. It's crazy. You'd be like, oh, spit it. I'm like, Soup Juice. I was like, yeah, you know, it's, you better copyright that.
Yeah, I'm working on it, actually.
$400 to copyright something.
Yeah, I'm working on it.
I've looked it up.
Yeah. Could be done.
Don't you do the duck lips?
Nope.
You did the duck lips a few times.
Yeah, I did. That's the only way. The only way I know how to pose is.
He even twerked that shit.
I believe that one. I've seen him drop it down low in Bemidji.
Pose or else this.
Yeah.
Wolf pack.
What about the time you dropped it low in Bemidji? He's like, oh, right there. And they even got the picture of it.
Yeah,
man.
that was actually
was
a pretty good.
Scared for them jeans.
I pulled a muscle. Yeah. They were really. I was maxing those jeans out as it was,
yeah.
Man. I had a lot to drink that night, and it was just barely held it all together.
Yeah.
But thank God I didn't have a wardrobe malfunction. But yeah, I was gonna about your. When did you realize your Soup Juice character was just taken off? Because that really blew up fast. It got big, and you got like how many friends on Facebook just like that? How long did it take you to get like 5,000 friends?
It took me approximately 3 months to get 5,000 friends. That's the max you can have on
mm-hmm.
Facebook. And now I looked into it. I got a 5,000 friends and 1,000 and 270 something followers, which is okay, you know. I'm satisfied with that, you know. Yeah,
I'm at like 260 some.
Wow, I'm at 18. Man,
just my,
of course, man. I mean,
he may make an appearance. But so you've been hitting it pretty hard lately, you know, comedy, doing some. You came up to Red Lake to speak to the youth for that conference last week. What was that like, being in front of a wall of humanity?
Well, that was good. I mean, like I said, it was for the youth and stuff, you know, and I get a good vibe back from the youth and stuff. I do a lot of that youth talking and stuff like that. Keep a positive nature in what I do and stuff, because the comedy and stuff is just one of the things that I like doing, you know. I like to talk and inspire kids as well, too. Mm-hmm. You know, I got a lot of good words to say for them. Mm-hmm. I consider the youth as our future, so it's good to do that for Red Lake.
Yeah.
I mean, they treated me good, and they still do today.
Mm-hmm. It was pretty... I didn't get to hear your speech, but a lot of people said it was pretty good. Was that your first time doing something like that, or...?
Actually, it was my third time. I've spoken for the Leech Lake Reservation, too. Spoke to the youth there, too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. And then, we did my... I had a 9-4 Warriors 20-year anniversary, and you were there.
Yeah, thanks, that was good too, man. That was fun. Enjoyed myself.
Yeah, it was just, man, that the crowd just loved you over there. It just, boom. You hear that? You hear that pop? You know, you can feel that pop when you're on stage, when you hit them just right. You could just. Yeah. I felt that for you there, and it was very rare to feel that for somebody else. And that was a nice crowd. Good, nice set you had there, and you. Went on a little longer than you're supposed to. No, just kidding. and then you were supposed to be there. This is the second time you backed out on us.
I know, man.
See, he's getting fired. I was getting fired. You're supposed to do a show with me and Tito in November. You didn't show up. You're supposed to do the 94 Warriors show. You didn't show up. Trying to get him to do the show here at me. Shows up, what, 20 minutes later?
I know, you know,
I'm
a businessman, I gotta take care of business, you know what I mean? I sell fried ribs. Just kidding. Now I was just running late. I know, I was like, I seen the time, and I was getting ready, you know, I was like, oh man, am I seeing quiet? The time was 5:39, I was blazing. I got your aid on a welcome, though, or, you know, I got that for you.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'll get together, like, a big... Native American comedy jam, like the Kings of Comedy. You know what I mean? Let's start our own, like the Sazz of Comedy.
You won't come. You won't show up.
I'll show
calling
up.
Us Sazz. Call us Sazz right to our face.
Come on, man.
Nobody's gonna like gonna come see a bunch of Sazz. Go to a party in Red Lake and see some Sazz.
Nah, seriously, man. I think if like, you know, we get you, Tito, what is it? Big S, little S. What is his?
Stu.
Stuart
Perkins. S2. I told you this last week.
He's funny.
S2.
That dude is crazy as hell.
But yeah, that was one of the things I brought up about, you know, with the passing of Charlie Hill in December. Mm-hmm. You know, that'd be a tribute to him. I put that out on Facebook, and I got a lot of positive responses on that. And a lot of the people are into it.
Yeah.
We just got to get everybody a schedule or a date for Seven Clans, an open date. Bring everybody in.
Awesome.
And we'll just like... awards type honoring him.
Yeah, I think that would be excellent.
I think it may be like
two, three
day festival. So. So that's in the works. Watch out for that.
I watched some of his stuff on YouTube the other day. I got he's a legend, man. Mm-hmm. He's funny as heck, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
He had a lot of good stuff on him, man. I just was like laughing harder than him. I was like, you know, I think. Who's the other big comedian from Canada?
McMahon?
No.
Howie Miller?
No. The older guy, Ponytail. He has the...
Burnstick?
Burnstick. I gotta admit, that's probably my favorite comedian.
Yeah.
Burnstick is just... He's outrageous. What if he'd ever do a show with us?
He won't.
You don't think he'd do a show with us?
No.
Think he's larger than us?
No, he just won't work with us.
He just won't work with us?
No, I've heard things. No,
yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Start some rumors.
I think
info out there.
You know, our people, man. You know, we're the type of people that our culture is where we all take care of each other. You know what I mean? It's like, everyone's a brother to, you know, to die. You know, it's just how it is. And I think, like, like this comedy thing, rap thing. Everybody's trying to help someone get up. Mm-hmm. You know, all other cultures, everybody's like, you know, they get mad at you or they say you ain't nothing. They don't help you. But in our culture, you know, we're like, all right, Soup Juice. And we share his videos. We like his videos. And we tell people to watch videos. See, mm-hmm. it's as a culture, we help each other out. Like the Johnny R Show, you know, I try to post it out there, tell people, you know, and that's it. Like, I think that's what you do as comedians is get together, get one big show and show people what we're about, you know, and just get you into it and stuff.
I tried that, but you didn't show up.
Twice. I'm going to get serious. I'm seriously into it now. My material I've been writing, I kind of fixed it up. I was a little bit rated X. So I'm going more rated R with it now. So, or maybe even PG-13. I don't know. I'm like, you know, when I do comedy, I do some crazy stuff. I say whatever the hell I want to say. You know what I mean? Remember that, John?
Hmm?
I think my best show was in Manoma. I mean, Cadillac? Wait, what was it? Were the first comedians do Cadillac?
I think so.
Yeah, so, I mean, Manoma, I think that was my best show. I mean, I was on it. Like, I think I had the flu and stuff when I was at Cadillacs. I had the flu. Didn't feel good, but
the shit.
I told you not to tell nobody. I threw those sharks away.
Not the sharks.
The sharks, man.
So what do you got coming up next then? Where are you headed? Is your schedule filling up pretty fast then, or?
Currently, I'm gonna be cruising out to Montana out to the Fort Peck Res. Gonna go show some love to the Montana natives. They always had my back from day one.
Beautiful, so beautiful
gotta
place.
Send some love to Montana. Gonna be out there with Milo and Tito. I believe is gonna be out there. And I'm looking forward to being out there and meeting some people. Also, I'm going to be bringing my shirts out to Fort Peck.
Nice.
Brand new Soup Juice shirts. So you guys want to check those out?
Nice.
It's got the hashtag on the booty. Keep some attention on it.
Nice. Yeah.
Boom.
Like
so I got all of those I'm going to take out there.
Mm-hmm.
Also, these will be going out to Thief River.
Wow.
Paul out there.
Mm-hmm.
Lady Juice will have all these rocking out there. So we're looking forward to selling a lot of shirts to all the good people out there.
Pick them up.
Yeah.
All over Indian country.
I give a shout out to my friend Vincent White Sr. He's a big time Soup Juice fan. Every time I'm at work, he's checking out Soup Juice. Check out it. You know, and he's out on my face. He's a big fan, man. And so, I mean, Vincent White Sr., he's like a big Soup Juice fan. So, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we're talking about your. What made you go from, you know, from the videos to the comedy, and then to the, you know, speaking to the youth. Was there a process you went through, or was it just, were they presented to you, or did you go out and, I want to do this for you guys, hire me? What was your,
Actually, the comedy kind of took me by storm, man. It just, mm-hmm. like, boom, came up. First, it was media, you know, I was doing it for the internet, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
And then I just asked a question one day, people would want to see Soup Juice on stage, and I got a lot of feedback from that, man. So I took it in mind, and the people were saying you need a manager and stuff like that.
Mm.
So I got a couple of those rocking for me too.
Yeah.
They're both doing a good job. Shouts out to my managers, you know who you are. Also, the motivational speaking stuff like that, where I come from, the Omaha Reservation, we're all kind of speakers like that to each other. So that comes like natural for me. I mean, it's all about, you know, being positive, stuff like that. I've been sober for a while, and I promote sobriety and stuff like that because I look at it as if you're going to do something good, you know, creator's watching you do and everything you're doing in life. And once you start doing something good for the people, there's going to be rewards in that.
Mm-hmm.
So I think what's happening is the rewards are coming to me, you know, little by little. So I'm getting a blessing out of it, as well as other people that are watching Soup Juice. They're getting a blessing and a healing from it too.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's all coming back to me in a good way. So I pretty much appreciate it for everybody out there that shares my videos, likes them, everything, comments on them, everything like that, man. And it's all because of them that I'm doing what I'm doing today.
Yeah, you know, this is the fans make the person, you know what I mean? And it's good to thank them all, and I know we appreciate it.
Oh yeah, and my team Soup Juice, man, is all of you guys, man. I want to give a big shout out to each of you. You guys are the one that made this silly little mask here. You guys made it what it is. Yeah.
So what, where did your idea of Soup Juice come from? Was it something you used to do, or was it a nickname you had as a kid, or?
Soup Juice, I always explain this a certain kind of way. Soup juice is a little bit of everybody that we all know.
Mm-hmm.
And the only way I can identify, I mean, we can all identify with him because he's a character, wild and out, crazy as hell.
Yeah.
But he's really based on one of my uncles back on my res. Mm-hmm. His name's John Lasley. He's still kicking today, crazy as hell. So I want to give a big shout out to my uncle John Lasley down there in Macy. He's a lot of his humor, Soup Juice, is based on Macy humor.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you ever go down Macy and chill down there, we're loud, cussing around, raising hell, everything. Mm-hmm. Pointing at you, teasing you, telling you what's wrong with you, pantsing you, packing you, everything. I mean, everything that's crazy. We do it all. Mm-hmm. And that's what this guy does, man. He just ain't afraid to say anything, says it all. A lot of people are saying Soup Juice says what a lot of people won't say.
Yeah.
So I kind of feed off from my fans and my people back home. People just told me to keep doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And I listen to the people. I keep doing it, man. Mm-hmm. Every day, all the time.
So when when you put on the mask, is it easier for you to be more outgoing, or is it just like what you would say normally with or without the mask?
I rode with a friend of mine coming back from Nepal in North Dakota. I jumped in with him, and I was kind of tired from the powwow, man, and I jumped in and got kind of quiet. He's a funny guy too, man, and he says, well, I'm going to post this on Facebook. Soup Juice really isn't the way he is on Facebook. I can hear the crickets, and I just busted out laughing. I was like, man, that's crazy as hell. I was like, oh, man. Yeah, like, all right, what's up, man? He's like, man, say something funny, man. So I just started going off on him, and it was a crazy ride home.
You never want to hear the crickets.
Yeah, that's what caught my attention.
When I'm around here, I get kids coming up to me, tell me a joke.
Yeah.
I think, well, you're not really that funny. You know, I thought you were supposed to be a comedian as well. It's just one of the things when you, like, with everyday life, everything, you want to lay low. You don't want to be, well, I don't want to bring attention to myself. You know, I just want to live. But once I'm on stage, it's a whole, I don't know what it is, getting up there.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just, has that not become a character? It's just what I have a mic now. I'm gonna say, you know, what's on my mind, and it people respond to that. And it's like you said, you know, you say something other people won't want to say.
Yeah,
that's just how I think. And
I think the first time I seen you was in Seven Clans. Me and Lady Juice, we was up there sitting there. I think we was sitting with your sister and your mom. Mm-hmm. I think. And yeah, I thought that was pretty good there. And I seen Tito and Von Eagleberry. He's one of my favorite comedians.
Yeah.
I seen them go up there, and I was like, man, that's some good stuff there. You know, just to have the whole crowd laughing all at once at what you're saying and stuff like that. I thought that was a pretty good blessing. Yeah. I just, you know, thought to myself, I wonder how it feels after the show to do something like that.
That's the, I don't know, you probably felt it in Bemidji there when you got done. It's like I always say hulking up, you know, get all fired up, and because you know you did well, you know you had fun, and everything was all working. And that's just how it's like a rush, a high.
It is, yeah.
And that's what keeps me wanting to try to get that high every time. You know, there's times where you're not gonna have it going. You know, you're gonna have a awkward set sometimes. I still have those, but you just keep going for that ultimate high. And it's addicting, man.
Oh, yeah.
It's addicting. You do whatever you can to get it. So, are we going to see some Soup Juice himself then, or?
Yeah, I'll show you how it's done. Right. I mean,
the process.
Yeah. You just take your hat off right here. I got the hat on, right? So,
yeah.
So I take the hat off. Mm-hmm. I clear my throat because then I take the hair out, the good hair. The good hair.
The warrior hair.
And it just goes over my ears like this, you see? It goes like that. And I put the mask on carefully, carefully. And it just goes over normally like this. And, there you go. You got that Soup Juice effect. In full effect, in full form, for the pups out there. This isn't for you. If you think you can change and be a certain kind of way, you can't do it like Soup. You little pups need to learn. It's a process. You hear? So that's how it's done, you know. You gotta prepare for things like this. It doesn't just happen overnight now. You see, it's an alter ego that Brian has. I say the stuff that he can't say. See, right now, Brian ain't gonna tell you them glasses look weird on you, but I tell you right now, them some ugly glasses. I wouldn't fly in a jet with them. Shit. I ain't even real gold. Shit. That looks fake. I'm just being honest with you, man.
That's cool with me, man.
Who wears Under Armour? Huh? Who wears that? Do you even work out? Do you jog?
Actually, I'm going to the gym after this. I'm going to get some scope first.
Stay there. You're going to get some scope, huh?
Yeah, I'm going to get some scope.
Ah, man. My mouth watering.
You want to share a joke?
God, I think I gotta get some coffee, man. You're making me get them jitters. My liver quiver.
Actually, bring 2 gallons of scone.
Nice. Enjoy. But hey, Johnny.
Yes.
I wanna. I posted this approximately 6 hours ago.
Mm-hmm.
It's Soup Juice Is. I always do this for my fans, my followers, and my peoples. I wanna read a couple of these comments they gave me. Now, this is. The people, I'd mind you, not my words, their words. Soup Juice Is probably using this pulse as a distraction while he's stealing your girl.
Nice.
Montel Campbell. Yeah.
Smooth,
oh, let's see, here's another one. Oh, goodness. Oh. Soup Juice Is cooler than a popsicle in the wintertime. Alaska, when it comes to this funny shit. Sorry, kids. Don't watch then. Plug your ears. Let's see what else. I know there's a couple crazy ones on here. Soup Juice Is funnier than a white man dancing in place. Nice. Lambert Garcia.
Stealing that one.
Yeah.
White guy dancing in place.
Sorry. Don Goggle Eye says, Soup Juice Is my love child, my chaske. This is what these guys are saying, John.
Man.
See here, one more. Winona Thompson says, Soup Juice Is good at splitting guts and butts. Jeez. Ouch. Oh, man. Wow.
Guts and butts.
Yeah. Oh, then these guys, they're really good. I just got this one in from Robert. Soup Juice Is a Red Lake Warrior.
Nice. The highest compliment ever.
The highest. Right? I had to finish it big.
There it is. It's
yeah.
Done, man.
Nice.
So you talk about scope all the time. Has that ever gotten you in trouble?
To be honest, no.
No?
I'm a closet drinker. I sip in the closet, I stay in the closet, I don't come out unless I'm good to go. I wear my clean cut clothes when I'm in public, I don't show it. It's a beauty I keep within. It's a pure beauty within my native soul. So you'll never see me with it.
True warrior.
True blue. That's right.
So you got any websites or what's your Facebook address?
I really don't go off of that. You know what? If you want to get a hold of me, you contact me through Facebook. Just send a message and I'll get back at you ASAP. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's people contacting me trying to order my shirts.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell them, I say, you know what? You got to wait till I come to you, man. It's because I'm thinking of doing it MoneyGram style. Thinking about it.
Yeah.
I might do it MoneyGram style. I don't know. I mean, I don't want to go PayPal because I heard PayPal was hacked. Yeah. That's just what I heard.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I mean, you just got to see me. Come to Bemidji or Red Lake or Cass Lake. You got to travel to get these shirts. But I'm working on it.
Just keep it old school. Money orders, man.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody ever steals a money order.
Nope.
I've done that a few times. So what you got Montana. Have you have anything after that then?
Montana. Or then first week in June, I'm heading out to the Yakima Nation Treaty Days powwow. Going over there, a friend of mine flying me and the lady out there. Big shout out to Resline Bullies. I'm going out there to do a shoot with them. So that's going to be something good out there in Fort Washakie. I mean, the Yakima area. Yakima. So I'll be doing that, clicking up with Resline Bullies. Beautiful dogs, beautiful animals. Mm-hmm. Papered, registered, everything legal. Boom. Do all the illegal stuff.
Yeah.
But that's what I'm about there, supporting them. Also, let me see here. A lot of other side gigs too. Like I said, I'm going to Montana.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna be over there. I'm looking forward to that one because I got a lot of peeps out there in Montana, mm-hmm. man. Shouts out to Milo. He gave me a call today. I don't know why I was talking to him. He's just driving, talking about nothing. I don't know.
He does that.
Yeah.
He does
that. Soup, what you doing? Nothing. What? I was just checking you out, man. What you up to? Shit. What? What do you want? Oh, I was just gonna... Oh, wait, I'm kind of nervous right now. I was like, what do you want, man? I tend to have that effect on him. I don't know. He tend to get nipply on me. I'm like, sorry. It's the hair. I don't know. But I want to give a shout out to Milo for giving me a call. I'll be trucking with him to Montana. Yeah.
Come on, as natives, how do we get that good hair? I want that good hair.
Well... You see, I've been growing this since I was a pup. This right here has been cut 4 times. It was down to my knees. When I trim it, I gotta trim it up about 3 or 4 inches because I get split ends. And I gotta keep it intact. I can't let no one else mess around with my hair. Only one touches my hair is Lady Juice. Otherwise, I'll be looking for any little itch I get, because I don't want to mess with my hair. I don't want to cut this. So it's a lot of preparation, and you got to pray for this hair. You can't just grow it out. I mean, I see you having troubles right now. But you know what? I'll pray for you, you know? I'll pray for you.
I'll give you some tobacco.
Ah. Washte, pilami alo. But I'll be praying for you. I'll let you have a secret of my good hair. Right. Not for everybody, but, you know, we all have our own looks.
Yeah.
So who are you? You came in the middle of this interview, and I'm wondering, who's this guy, John? I was like, shit.
Well, if you ever watch it, John, you know,
yeah, I do.
Well, the idea came is he was going to interview me one day. We were outside in winter time at the Powell Grounds.
Yeah.
And, He did this interview with me on it, and I just kicked it. Everyone liked it. And so he asked me to be the co-host, so I said, yeah. And so
nice.
We did a lot of work together, and I started coming late, and he fired my ass for not showing up for a couple gigs. And
gotta be on time, man.
It's the business,
on
baby.
Time.
My stage name is Big Superman. And I started my own show called Brandon Wayne Show. And
gotcha.
I mean, right now, people don't really... you know who I am at the time, but once, you know, I think once they get to know me, I'm one of those comedians that are fucking just kick your ass kind of comedian.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
I don't give a F word, you know. Mm-hmm. Can you just swear? You let me swear at the comedy show. Mm-hmm. You said no swearing, and so I hold back.
Limit your
adjust.
Gotta adapt.
But that's who I am, man. I mean, I wasn't a lot. How many shows? I've been on a lot of shows with you, didn't I?
I don't know.
If you want to put on a
full,
right now,
full season. Really? You want some?
All I want is the soup juice.
Oh, that's what I thought. So I got my belt in the van.
Give me
the.
All I want
is
the soup juice. This guy was so buff himself. She might beat me too. I don't know.
She wrestles me.
Okay, all I want is Johnny.
She wrestles me, man. I would not advise you to wrestle with Juice, lady. No.
After I saw her,
I'm telling you, man. It's not easy. It's tough.
Yeah, we have a thing going on. Me and this guy beat him in arm wrestling. We carried around the border for years on the match.
Oh my goodness.
All right, man. That's any final departing words for the pups?
Well,
I want to say... I want to tell the story about my my girls. The older one and the younger one. We were riding in the car. The younger one. I said, hey, who wants to sit up in front? The older one jumped up there. I am, because I'm older. The younger one looked at her. Man, I wish I was older. So the older one looked at her and said, you should have swam faster. Oh, shit. I said, ah, jeez. But anyways, I want to give a shout out to Tisha, my manager. And Fort Peck, get ready. Also, Yakima Nation, get ready. Treaty days. Other than that, thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming on, man. That was awesome.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Oh, good shit, man. Oh. Refresh record. Whoops.